adjustment this year. Is there anybody you want to give a shout out turning your season around?
I think just the support from everybody here, my teammates, the staff, our catching core that we had here this year, and just each other. I think just, we never gave up, and that helps on an individual basis. So it's been a really fun year, but we're here.
I can see why you get people out on base. You're calm as a cat.
Sometimes. I've learned over the years.
Go have fun. Thanks for your time.
Beautiful picture.
Show when you came back, the homeless, the army. the clutch hits. What does it mean to you knowing how much you help this team?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, you want to make an impression when they go out and get you, and you know, you want to help the team win. Like you said, I think I did that, and I think there's more in the thing.
Last year, you got hurt in the playoffs. That really hurt us, a lot of us. Are you on a mission next time, this time around?
Yeah, I mean, for sure. Obviously, it didn't end the way I wanted it to end. And from a personal standpoint, getting hurt, and then obviously from a team standpoint, we were so close. So, you know, being able to get back in, and, you know, once you get in, anything can happen.
Want to give a shout out to anybody right now?
My family back at home, mom and dad, my brother, my in-laws, and my wife and my son up in the stands. I can't wait to see you. So.
You're so easy to pull for. Well done. I'll let you go celebrate. League in RBIs, Ryan Snitker watched his offense explode. The Braves in this final kick won 10 of their last 11 games. There are 7 players, Jeff, on this team with 10 RBIs in September. The offense really would have spread around, but offense is only part of the story. The Braves pitching down the stretch was great, including Max Fried, who's standing by with Paul Byrd. Paul?
Here with Max Fried, athlete, hitter, also a good pitcher. 1.74 ERA in the second half. What does that feel like? See that money falling by.
It's just the culmination of all our hard work and trials. And, you know, running. Yeah, I mean, it obviously wasn't the prettiest year. You know, we had a lot of ups and downs, a lot of injuries, a lot we had to fight through. So to be able to finish on top and win the division again, it's everything that we've worked for. Now that the fun starts.
How about this crowd chatting for your teammates, Freddie and others?
Unbelievable. Yeah, these guys deserve it, especially Freddie. How amazing and how great he's been this year, starting off to not the great start, having just, you know, one of the hottest stretches in baseball, and just being that consistent, stabilizer for us. It's amazing. And to have these, you know, amazing fans come out, it helps us a lot. You can feel the energy in that.
Here you go. This is what I want.
Right now in the Atlanta clubhouse, Ryan Snitker is division clinching speech, and then the champagne celebration begins here at Truist Park, Jeff.
Man, no wasting a whole bunch of expensive champagne.
Just even for a minute after this long year, but now the fun part.
To four cameramen.
How satisfying and gratifying must that be for that group of 26 players? Braves used much more than that this year, obviously, Jeff. But again, all that this team has overcome, that has to be one of the proudest moments of their professional careers.
I think you heard the emotion from Snit when he was talking to Kelly a little bit ago. It's just by far the most gratifying for him out of the 4 division titles. And like I said, it goes back to what they went through for 4 months. They were a 500 team and below. And all of a sudden, they turned it on the last 2 months and showed why they were the best team in the NL East.
Yeah, there's so many signposts for this team. You recall in early May, they lost Travis d'Arnaud in Dunedin, Florida. Tore a thumb ligament. He was out. He was one of 7 catchers that the Braves used this year. In Boston, Marcelo Zuna broke his fingers. He was lost. Then you lose Acuna right before the All-Star break. Then the Braves, hovering around 500, find a way. That 5-4 road trip through Philadelphia and New York against the Mets got them to within 4 games of the trading deadline. Alex worked his magic. And then finally, a game once again won their 4th straight division title. So a lot to celebrate in Atlanta, not just with the players and staff, but with Derek Schmidt, the Braves team president. He's standing by with our own Kelly. Yeah. Kelly?
There he is, the one. Is that him over on the right top?
Watching that imagery we just saw of this team celebrating, you said that's pretty darn cool. What is this moment like for you, having watched with this team and the adversity they faced come out on top here with a 4th straight division title?
You know, I know we've obviously poured champagne before. We've won division championships before. But in a lot of ways, this one feels really different. Perhaps it's the year plus that we've all overcome. The fact that we didn't have
doing all this in front of Braves country, I think it's extra special. What the guys overcame this year, you know, all the injuries, all the adversity, you know, go back just a month ago, and I think there was a lot of doubters and wondering whether, you know, we had it in us. And so it's a great group of guys, obviously, in that clubhouse, and they deserve all the champagne they can pour out right now.
Absolutely. You could use the word, and we've heard it, survival for this season. They survived, and they had the trade deadline. Alex Anthopoulos really went to work and added some pieces that maybe had them in this position, you have to say.
Well, I don't think I'm going to be the first to say this, but I think you should get executive of the year. There's a lot of people that obviously did great things for their teams, but I don't think anybody did what Alex did for this team in that trade deadline. And while not a single one of them was necessarily the front page of the newspaper type of trade, all of them collectively got us to where we are, and he's just, you know, obviously an amazing executive and, you know, deserves all the credit.
I think 28 guys standing here tonight, but it took 54 to get to this point. When you speak to that depth and the resiliency of this group, what does it say about what lies in front of them?
Well, look, I mean, this is a chapter, but it's not the ending chapter. This is, in a lot of ways, this is the start. You know, we didn't do this so that we could just be done before the champagne field. We are obviously very interested in trying to win the World Series. That's been our goal. That is our goal. That's what we're going to try to shoot out to do. And obviously, nothing would be better than to win a World Series here in Atlanta in front of this crowd who supported us so much this year. And we're obviously believers in attendance the whole year. This
team is playing really good baseball. So you feel good about how everything's going right now. I'm so happy for all of these guys. Ryan Snicker, my favorite ever. To be able to celebrate with his grandkids is unbelievable, too. But all these guys deserve credit. All of them put the hard work in. Long season. Much deserved victory today.
You know, this is the fourth year in a row. We have seen Steve be such a genuine, great human being. Everybody loves that guy. They know him. I'm so happy for him. The timeline of this season, as you guys have alluded to, was remarkable. There was a time where people, you know, beginning of the season, Braves are the team to beat. The Benny Champs is the team to beat the division. Mets loaded up. Philly's gotten a little bit better. Everybody was getting better. Like, what are the Braves doing? And the next, you know, injury. And they bring in Jack Peterson. And he contributes right away. And then the three outfielders come over. You got four outfielders. You're hoping just two of them contribute. All four did. That was remarkable, right? Remarkable.
No, it was. And, you know, when we made those trades, it was players that won with a team where they weren't performing well. And we knew the talent that they had. And all of a sudden, they got new life. And that's what is so important about your scouting. You got to give a lot of credit to the scouts here for the Atlanta Braves that went back to Alex Anthopoulos and said, these guys have the potential to be great and to bring this team to victory. And Soler, struggling, comes here and he looks like a totally different player. He had 49 home runs, 48 home runs before. Well, he returned to that player just in time for the Braves. They give credit to John Peterson when he came over. He gave us some instant life. And Eddie Rosario, when he came off the IL, he showed why Alex went after him. He's a 5-tool player. He can get it done. And, man, you can't say enough about Adam Duvall, a guy that I thought we should have kept.
Yeah.
We lost him
a few times,
but we brought him back because, and I remember interviewing Alex, who said he got mad at me saying all the yah-yahs for Duvall when he was with Miami beating us. So I'm just happy we brought him back because he really took over.
Yeah, how amazing is it? Adam Duvall almost cost us the